cash. So
it's really silly. So yesterday I was thinking about how the fan, it's actually a physics process. Like, it has to be in a shape that push particles so you can feel that wind coming to you. It's really silly.
Es magia, ¿no? En estos, a este nivel es magia.
So I start thinking of galaxies as people, or
una pequeña anécdota es que mi hijo, cuando estaba chiquito, un día le dije, ay, es que ya se está metiendo el sol. Y él me dijo, mamá, el sol no se mete, la Tierra gira. Y tenía como 3 años.
When I was thinking about conservation of angular momentum, things like that, I just thought, oh yeah, the first thing you do when you push someone, what is the first thing you do when someone pushes you up? Well, you lift your hands up a little bit, right? If someone pushes you, you put your hands up. You don't know that, but you learn by intuition by many times that helps you. But why does that help you? That changes your moment of inertia, right? So that changes the moment of inertia, makes it harder to move, to rotate. So then you can stay stable a little longer.
I study galaxies, and like I like knowing how these galaxies evolve if they are in an environment that is high density, which means like you have a bunch of other galaxies just around them. How this galaxy evolves and in that environment, how it evolves in an environment that is low density, which is there's few galaxies, like you rarely get to interact with one of them. And so one thing that I get to see every day is people. And so when I go to Costa Rica and I fly into San Jose and I get into the airport, the Juan Santa Maria airport, and I drive towards the capital, tons of traffic, tons of people around. I could see people walking by in the main like avenue, and I see people walking very close to one another, like they have their own paths. So I start thinking of galaxies as people, people as galaxies, and I start thinking of like their interactions that people have within themselves in that region, in their past lives, how all their experiences have influenced the person that they are today and right now. And that to me is very similar to how I study galaxies, how galaxies' interactions and history has influenced them to become what they are right now.
Para mí, algo donde la física tiene un papel muy importante todos los días, y en lo que estoy pensando también bastante seguido, es en la cocina. No sé, desde tratar de usar, tienes por ejemplo las transiciones de fase, cuando estás sirviendo el agua, pero también luego pasan cosas raras, como, no, pues, por ejemplo, cuando pones un poco de agua a calentar en el horno de microondas y no hierve, pero le pones una bolsita de té y empieza a hervir. O cuando pones algo muy frío en el congelador, como una cerveza, y no está congelada y le pegas tantito y se congela.
The breaking of things. That's my topic. That's my thing. I used to break so many things. Still I do. So that fascinates me too. Like when I break a bowl, when I break a toy or something that I really like, or it's not mine from a friend, it's like, oh. So yeah, those type of processes I think about a lot, and I think with physics that's the way you understand those processes and start giving solutions or improvement for those. The ceramics, for example, that's the material I study. They have a lot of applications and capabilities, but they have one disadvantage, which is the brittleness. And the idea would be to fix that so we can apply to more everyday situations.
I think it's when I see the bridges especially like the there's tended cables and all that. When I saw, I think about the tension and like the torque, how many like force do you need to hold these, how many like weight it will hold the limits. That's, I think I love that. See the implementation of like civil work, I love that. Yeah, I think that's what I get to see the most.
Sí, pues realmente para mí es todo. Porque estás metido, o sea, toda tu vida, todas las comodidades que tienes en la vida, muy probablemente vinieron de algún estudio de algo de la física. Entonces, por ejemplo, a mí me gusta ser consciente de cómo la física está detrás de todo en nuestra vida, especialmente en las cosas invisibles, como por ejemplo los campos electromagnéticos, que nos permiten tener la red de internet sin inalámbrica, o los controles remotos, por ejemplo. Uno ya da por hecho, prendes la tele o ya tienes tu internet en toda tu casa, pero estás inmersa en un campo electromagnético que pues, es algo físico. Tengo un muy gran respeto por la física y me gusta inculcárselo, por ejemplo, a mis hijas. Porque pues ellas son unas niñas que para ellas es magia, ¿no? A este nivel es magia, tengo internet y mis películas por magia, el microondas es magia, pero a mí me gusta mucho enfatizarles, no, ¿sabes qué? Es que ahí hay un campo invisible que nos permite pues tener estas comodidades. Entonces sí, sí me gusta hablar de eso.
Una de las cosas que más me gusta explicar, que es algo muy común y que lleva miles de años, que la humanidad sigue viendo miles de años y me sorprende que no se explique más, es por qué el cielo es azul. La explicación de por qué el cielo es azul es impresionante. ¿Por qué las nubes son blancas? ¿Por qué algunos atardeceres son tan rojos? Eso la humanidad lo ha visto durante toda su estadía aquí en la Tierra y muy pocas personas son capaces de realmente explicarlo. Entonces, un fenómeno tan sencillo como eso, que es explicado por la física, que cuando sales de tu casa lo ves y lo entiendes, es bastante interesante. Y ya de ahí pasar a por qué me reflejo en el espejo, por qué cuando limpio el piso se ve como un espejo también. O sea, cosas muy, muy sencillas en el día a día.
Yes, yeah, absolutely. And sometimes I still teach ballet class and I try to talk about it in terms like this, so conservation of angular momentum and then for example how in dance there's always like these leaps, and we always talk in dance about staying suspended in the air, and clearly from a physics point of view this is impossible, and so the question is, how do you create that illusion of being suspended in the air? And so the idea is you have to shift your center of mass. Basically, as you lift your legs, your center of mass drops. And since your center of mass is still following this parabola, it actually looks like you're maintaining the same height because your torso stays at the same height, even though your center of mass is actually following this parabola. And so it's, you know, all these things that are fun to analyze from physics, from mechanics.
So this is a funny anecdote. Actually, this was not me, but a close friend, of how in unusual circumstances you are thinking of physics. And so this is a good friend of mine who's Chilean, by the way. And once we were walking around in Central Park, and having a really nice day, and we just sat down, and it was late at night, maybe around 10 p.m. and we're just actually, it was a beautiful full moon. And so we sat now, and someone else, Bulgarian, another very good friend of mine, Bulgarian, and he's a mathematician. So all of a sudden we were all in silence. We were tired from a long day, and he asks, like, oh, he said, well, this is such a beautiful moon and it's a nice day. What are you thinking about? And I was thinking about a romantic moment and how nice would it be to spend that moment with a person, with an important person, with that beautiful moon. But the first one to answer was my Chilean friend, and he replied, I was thinking, how would you design the machine that cuts the green beans in such a perfect way. And so he started talking about the optimizing a process and some machinery. So I was thinking about the moon and the light and the stars, and he was thinking about science.
Being a physicist makes me, it is so much of who I am. And my family knows, like my family actually kind of hates me because I'm just always thinking about physics and bringing up physics and like having them notice things that happen, right? And like, I'm one, and I mentioned this earlier, as a kid, like I used to just walk and like look at shadows and be like, oh, that's interesting. How is that happening? I still do that. So like every day I have to, if I find a, the other day, for instance, I was standing here at my desk and then there was a light, like a reflection or something. I saw sunlight on my wall here. There's a window here. So where did the light, like the light can't be there. And I looked at my bookshelf and I don't have anything extraordinarily shiny back there. And I couldn't work. I couldn't do my work because I had to figure out where this light was coming from. And I had to sit here and think about it. And it was amazing actually, because what it was I have these two amazing little ecosystems in a flask. This is called a culture flask. And so they have algae at the bottom and shrimp inside. And so I had one of them under my desk and then I had one of them in the window. And what was happening is the sun was setting and the sun was coming in, hitting the inside of this. So it was total internal reflection. So then it was bouncing off of this onto this other one, which was then bouncing onto my wall. And it was a whole, like, it took me a good while to figure out what was happening, but that's just how I am. And the quarantine has kind of made it worse because now I'm always thinking about physics.